No time to celebrate, Dick. Making it to the Final Four means you have two games left. Only one team will make it to the championship after tonight's game between the Duke Blue Devils and the Gonzaga Bulldogs. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Bulldogs should be looking at a tough fight tonight, Dick. What have they got to do to win this thing?
They've got to stick to their game plan and focus on these keys. First, get a hand up in the face of all the outside shooters. Next, don't let their big man become a factor offensively. Keep him off the block, push him away from the low box, and force him to shoot jump shots. Thirdly, it's imperative that you win the battle of the boards.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They look to get it to the inside for the bucket. Perfectly executed. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Trying to feed inside. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket. Up it inside.
Gave it up. The shooting guard with the ball. Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline. He may be in trouble here, Brad.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you. Trying to go inside.
And he'll kick it back outside. The small forward gets the pass. Number 30 is charged with the foul. First team foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
With the free throw. It goes in. Gets two at the charity stripe. He goes for three. Way off target. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Number two is feeling great right now.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Number 42 fakes the shot for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
From the baseline.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
Dumps it in. Takes the pass in the paint. Jumps in. There appears to be a mismatch in the post. He makes the block. The Blue Devils have a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Number 42 takes the feed. Number 42 with the fake. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so is the defense, and they do a nice job. There's the rejection. They run it up into transition. And the slam. Oh. moving it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a double team waiting there. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Number three takes it away.
Slam jam, bam, up and away, the elevator man, they love it. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
Drops the bucket despite the harm. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Brunson first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Here's the drop step in the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
Looks at a three.
Great job of running the defender into the screen for the nice J.
They move it into the front court. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Looking for a good shot. Number 21 takes the pass. Here's a double team. They work the perimeter. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
10 on the shot clock. He nails the shot. Pass in the paint, tries for two, can't get the shot to go. He looks for the bomb. He nails the bucket.
That's a 9-0 run.
Forward gets the ball. Another turnover.
We're not talking out for turnovers either.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. A change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition. Great anticipation defensively. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
I think they're trying to make a statement. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit. The frustration right there.
He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
He tries the three. Way off target. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their voice is beginning to fade. They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
Buried it.
That's a 15-0 run.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. Throws it up. Leans in. This one might have been over before it started, Dick.
Yeah, it's been one-sided so far. Still plenty of time left, though.
Launches away. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. On the inside. He got the bucket and the foul.
Hey, the foul in the act couldn't stop him, baby. He wanted that bucket.
Number 21 going to the line for the first time tonight. Cashed it in.
They scored 20 in a row.
For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Basket falls despite the contact. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
And I think she's right about that, Richie.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you have a great post play. You got a chance really to win.
Entry pass in the paint.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Goes up for two. And off the mark.
Inside.
Gave it up. Stop and pop. Way off target. Turns it over. Both teams are looking to get something going here. He puts it in with contact and all. He intercepts it. We might have ourselves a blowout here.
Looks that way, Brad. It's been a very lopsided outing so far.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He's money with the shot. Let's it fly. Drains the shot. He's getting lost on every move.
We got to see more heart on defense.
On the dribble, gives it up. He fires from long range. Off the rim and no good. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, down here on the sidelines, it looks like the losing team is starting to get a little bit anxious. Their coaches are reminding them just to relax. My observation is it looks like these bright lights have gotten the best of this team so far in the first half.
Pushing that basketball.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
On the outside.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
They work it around the perimeter. Picked out of the air. With a quarterback pass. Duke on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Gave it up. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. He's got a nice shot fake. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He gets the rejection. And the ball goes out of bounds. Got a man in high post. Here's the three ball. Way off target. Had a momentary look from three-point land. From the top of the circle. Outside three. Got it. Looking for a good shot. Takes the pass in the paint. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Jumped in front to take it away.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle. A poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
Number 42 goes to the line for the first time. First one is no good. It's his second. He shoots from downtown. Gonzaga are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Tries for two. He hits the shot. Good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
They work it around the perimeter.
Double team now, bad angle.
Off the rim and no good. He launches the bomb, way off target. He rejects it. Off the rim and no good. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Too much. That's a foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Visit the charity stripe. Sinks it. And he got them both. Pull up jumper from way out. Way off target.
Oh, right there. They missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
Off the rim and no good. Takes away the pass. They work the perimeter for the bucket.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic. Up and inside.
Picked off. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Working it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Had him in the low block, but opted against it.
There's the trap.
He shoots from left of the circle.
How many bricks have we seen? Will somebody make a jump shot, please?
Working around the perimeter from three-point territory.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
There's a double team waiting there.
Get that sucker out of the game, man. 2-for-1 opportunity.
The dribble, gives it up, and he'll kick it back outside. They've left him completely alone. Looks at the three.
And the bricks just keep on coming, baby.
I have to start looking for some easier baskets here, Dick.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
He puts up the three ball. Way off target. On the outside. In the paint. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
At the half, the Bulldogs are trailing by 22. We've had a good one so far, Dick. What play stands out for you in the first half?
You have to talk about this trifecta for the highlight of the first half, Brad. After this shot, you really saw the defense have to stretch out, which opened up the inside game.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Number 15 hasn't really weathered the storm in the first half. He's really only had an average half, and their team is way behind.
I wouldn't worry too much, Brad. Don't be surprised to see the offense go through him more often in the second half. If there's anyone who can get them out of this bind, it's him.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land.
Not getting enough motion on offense. Here they are in transition, Brad.
Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Dump it inside.
Takes the pass in the paint. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The point guard receives the ball.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
There's the pick.
It's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
They'll work it around the arc. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
He attempts the three. Off the rim and no good. Those long arms trying to get him in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing. That big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
He doesn't get the hoop. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Tries for two. And he missed. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. For two. Lays it up. The Bulldogs are down by 20. They work the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
They're working around the perimeter. For three. Makes it.
Let's go to the videotape for that one.
Throws it up from downtown. Drains it. The power forward handles the pass.
They let him get into a rhythm.
Puts up the tray. He gets the shot to fall. It's stolen. Kicks it out. The point guard handles the feed. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position, spreading his body and getting the ball.
Working it around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. And one too many dribbles and a steal. Number 30 picks up the he gets the bucket to drop and gets the foul.
He felt the pressure on the way up, but managed to keep himself focused on the rim. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
That's a 9-0 run.
Number 22 is called for the defensive foul. Third personal foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Out there, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Hits the second. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Strips the ball. That was nice.
Take a look right here. Nobody steps into the driving lane. He allows him to get the crease, the lane, the angle.
Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
He dials long distance, way off target. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up. You get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass. Oh, what a strip, Brad.
Way out on top, controlling the ball.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer. Up and inside.
Takes the pass in the paint. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
On the outside, got a wide open look. He pump fakes. There they come with a double team to stop it. He comes away with it. They get it out into transition.
I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a Skywalker. Elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nessler. How much fun would that be?
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Jump hook from the low post. Gonzaga are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Goes for the deep one. The Blue Devils have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Great pressure, great double team. Really.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And off the mark. Looking for a good shot. Gave it up. Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
The ball goes out of play. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nessler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor.
He does the sweet fake shot. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
They work the perimeter. He shoots from outside. That was nice.
Number
The shooting guard receives the pass, makes the shot. Here's a double team. Nice shot fake. Tries for two. Contact on the shot attempt causes the misfire. On the dribble, gives it up. Picked off. On the inside.
Double team now, bad angle.
The fake. For the bucket. Gonzaga have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
Number 25 is trying to get the crowd fired up.
He wants everyone up for the next possession.
Goes up for two. Doesn't go.
Great vision. Look at him, head up.
He blocks the shot.
High post screen.
Here they go into transition. Number 42 draws the personal. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He is going to the line. Makes the first shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Misses the second shot.
Nice fake.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, it's obvious their backs are against the wall. It's going to take a lot of fight and desire to get back into this one. Defensive stops are the words that come to mind, and without them, they just don't have a chance.
Fakes it. And he'll kick it back outside. The shot from the baseline. Off the mark. Off the lazy pass. This could be something special. Tries for two. In and out. Tries to draw the charge, and even he has to smile about this one.
I tell you, kidding me, that's one of the great acting jobs of all time. Give him an Oscar.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
From beyond the arc, not this time. For the bucket, they still don't score. They go with the entry pass, on the post, turnaround jumper. Off the rim and no good. The ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
He's got a high post flasher. Great defense. Goes up for two. Gonzaga are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they'll keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
Takes the pass in the paint. Time to pick up the defense here now.
Turnover City, now always really negate any offense.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip. Going one way, you spin back the other way.
Going to move it around the perimeter. Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Gave it up. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
There's the pick. No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
He takes it away. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Now they work it around the perimeter. They're working around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
On the dribble, gives it up. Takes away the pass. In the paint. Gets it back out. And he'll kick it back outside. For the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
They can't keep these guys from scoring.
Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. Takes the pass in the paint. And now they'll bring it up. And the ball goes out of play. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat. Up and inside.
He shoots from the top of the key. He hits the shot. Picked out of the air with the fake. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Sinks the shot.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Goes up for two, and he scores despite the hack. For the deuce. Perfectly executed. Gets it back out. Working it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Rims out. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball.
The basket catch for the deuce, and they'll send him to the line.
He's a meat and potatoes kind of guy, Brad.
Was the made basket the meat or the potatoes, Dick?
Hey, that was the meat and the potatoes. Now he's going to the line for the gravy.
He'll get one. Got it! Oh, big time screen set on the defender. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
For two, off the rim and no good. And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from left of the circle. No good from the field. Gave it up. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I thought he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
On the outside. Shots there if he wants it. Rims out. Tries for two. The lay-in. Double team doesn't work.
Hey, weak side's got to be ready to attack the ball.
On the outside. In the post. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Step out on that screener.
Steals the pass. On the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. Off the rim and no good. He intercepts it. Gave it up. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
He throws it up from downtown. He pulls down the board. Picks off the pass. For the deuce. Sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Look at that spacing.
He puts up the tray. Rims out. He's money with a shot. Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Aaron's right about that. We're ready to get back to the action. 6 points is the difference.
Wow, do they need a basket badly, Brad? Momentum will decide it.
Let's it fly. Off the rim and no good. Intercepted. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
He launches a three. Got it. Leveled by the defender on that pick. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick.
Now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
He goes to the line for the first time. Sinks it. hits that one.
Timeout! Hey, these kids are driving me crazy, Brad. This game is too close. I'm starting to sweat, baby. Oh, the pressure.
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
They'll throw this one in from the side. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Gets it.
They need a basket here to turn this into a one possession game.
He goes for the trifecta. Rims out. Jumped in front to take it away. I get a feeling they've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
From downtown, knocks it down. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Blue Devils completes a five-game winning streak with a big, big win today.
I'll tell you one thing, the coach doesn't want five, baby. He wants the Super Six, because the six means the national championship, and they're ready to win number six and win the NCAA championship.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.